Hey everyone, so if you have watched the state of Unreal in GDC 2024, you might be familiar with all the changes that were announced for version 5.4, including the changes in animation system which took a massive transformation and blew our minds away. So two of the major features, including the advanced auto retargeting and the modular control rig, completely transformed what was once a slow, cumbersome and complex procedure into an intuitive, streamlined and surprisingly fun process. So in this video, we are going to dive into these enhancements and show you how they can be leveraged across different skeletal meshes. So let's get started. So I have downloaded this sample Mixamo model for our today's demonstration. So first we are going to create an IK rig for our Mixamo character. So let's open this. In the previous skeletal mesh, we will choose our Mixamo mesh. So previously, we used to go through all the trouble of creating the IK chain map one by one manually. Now we have this button, auto create retarget chain. So the system understands that this is a Mixamo skeleton and it creates the retarget chain map accordingly. So this system has basically compatibility with different type of industry standard skeletons that you have used in various applications like maybe Dash, iClone and so on. And they are all going to be easily retargetable over here. Pretty cool, right? You can also create the IK goals with a single click by clicking on the auto create IK. So it creates a full body IK by default. If you are interested in other types of IK, please check out my other tutorial. Here I can see a minor issue that can be very easily fixed by reversing the preferred angles over here. So now let's open this RTG mannequin that comes with our mannequin character. In the target IK rig asset, we will choose our Mixamo IK rig. Yeah, so here we can see a few issues. That's because the poses are not matched. So let's go to the editing retarget pose, and in the auto align, I will choose align all bones. What this does, it automatically aligns the target bones to match with the source pose. In the other tutorial, you have seen me manually do this thing, like rotate each of the bones so that they all align with the source pose. But here it's all happening in just a few clicks. I mean, retargeting has suddenly become so fun and interesting. So here we see another issue where his left upper hand is not correctly oriented. We can fix that very quickly by changing the pole vector offset of the left arm from 0 to 180. We can retarget the Paragon character very similarly, so let's do that. With just two clicks, I am setting up the IK chain and the IK goal. And it works even better with the Paragon character since it's an epic compatible skeleton. The IK retargeter over here is also pretty simple and straightforward. And this works flawlessly for the mannequin as well as the metahuman. Let's see how this works with Mixamo. First thing we are going to do is align the bones to match the source. And then we need to set the pole vector offset of the left arm. Yeah, here I can see issues in its feed, so I will go back to editing the retarget post. I had already aligned it to match with the source. So now I just have to manually adjust the left and the right feet. Now the animation looks much better. Now let's look into implementing the modular control rig, and for that I will go to the animation section in the context menu. In the control rig option, I will choose control rig, and over here I need to select modular rig. So first in the preview scene settings, I will select my preview mesh. Now it comes with the root control by default, as you can see, and in the center you see this round button which indicates that we have to drop the spine rig module on top of it. So in the left you have your module assets that you need to drag one by one, and over here you have the rig hierarchy. All the controls that you add are going to appear over here, and you can also directly add the controls in here, just like how you do in the control rig blueprint. So now let's add our modules. I will start with the spine. I will just drag it and place it in the socket. So this brings up a group of other sockets that are connected to the spine socket, and we're going to place the respective modules one by one over here. Sometimes you can misplace, so you can simply delete from the module hierarchy and reposition. And this tool is not very perfect, it has a lot of issues still. Even the undo redo doesn't work all the time, and a lot of times I had really messed up and I had to start all over again. So in your rig hierarchy you can see all the controls that have been automatically created when you dragged the modular rigs. Typically in your control rig blueprint you would have to create individual controls manually. So this approach is actually very effective and time saving way of quickly creating controls around your character that you can of course manipulate in the sequencer to create custom animations. So by default your arm rig is FK, so you can change that by checking the FK icon default in the details panel of your arm module. This will ensure that you are able to use basic hand IK. So I can create the modular rig for the metahuman as well, very similarly. Along with the base preview mesh, we can also add additional meshes from the skeletal meshes array. Now let's quickly set up the modular rig assets. This add control rig asset that you see over here is going to be useful for you if you are looking to add a control rig for specifically a particular bone. And this chain rig is going to create a hierarchy chain for any given set of bone hierarchy that you are looking for. So here you need to specify the start bone and the end bone. So I can simply choose one of the fingers as a part of the chain link hierarchy. So now we are going to test this in the sequencer. So in the level, I edit my actor, and in the sequencer, I'm going to add the reference. By default, it's going to load the default MetaHuman control rig, but we need to test ours, so we will delete the previous control rig. And now we can add the new control rig. So let's check if everything is working. Oh, okay, I see a weird issue going on over here, and that's probably because of the improper connection of this chain link. So we need to go back to our modular rig editor and fix it. Yeah, this is totally wrong. So yeah, let's quickly delete this, and basically we need to redo it. So whatever you do in the editor, I strongly advise you against pressing undo, because that is totally messed up. And even if I press undo to reverse something, I almost never recover to the point that I can make it work again flawlessly. So typically what I do if I mess something up by pressing undo or for whatever reason, I usually close the editor without saving and then reopen, and then it works fine. Maybe this is a bug or something that might get fixed in the later version. Till then, I will be cautious while working so that I don't lose my changes. And this is just a preview version I'm working on, so a lot of bugs are already expected, and a lot of things are going to get fixed in the release version when it launches later next month. So I will now drag my chain rig model inside one of the finger sockets. So if I want to add this in my index finger, I will just drag this on one of the index finger sockets. So the hand IK is now working fine. Index finger chain also works correctly. Alright, so let's go back to my sequencer now. Yeah, so it is working fine now. So in the State of Unreal demo, they had shown how a single finger control can be used to manipulate all the fingers. For our right hand, we are going to create something very similar. The process is not very straightforward, and for this I will be using this chain link. First, I need to create the controls for each of the fingers, starting with the index finger. Now here you see a lot of different sockets that you might be tempted to put your chain link on, but I must warn you, not all of them work. I have seen that I get the expected result when I am adding my chain link to either the side in or the side out sockets. Alright, so let's add the chain module in our index finger. So the start bone is going to be the index 1 and the end bone is the index 3. Okay, so I can change the shape of the gizmo, and to do that I will go over here under shape name. I will just change the name to arrow thick. Alright, so now let's set up the middle finger. So we are going to set up the start bone and the end bone over here. And if I want to make this chain dependent on the index finger chain, then I have to set up the parent control. So the parent control is going to be the index 1 control. Okay, so the parent control is still showing null. That's because we actually need to make this as a child in the hierarchy as well. So I will just drag this in the parent chain. Alright, so this works perfectly. So now we can set up the rest of the fingers. We can rename the chain links so that they are easy to identify. Okay, so now I'm going to set up the bones for each of these chains. So except for the thumbs chain, I want the movement of the chain modules for the rest of the fingers to be dependent on that of the index finger. So I will add the remaining ones as well as a children of the index chain. So now let's quickly change the shapes of the remaining gizmo chains. Yep, so this is working perfectly fine. With just the movement of the index finger chain, I am able to move the remaining fingers. And the thumb chain is moving separately. So now let's go back to our sequencer and try this out. Yeah, working as expected. It's even fun to trying this out inside the sequencer as compared to in the control rig editor because of all the clutteredness of node sockets over there. So now we are ready to animate our character, but I'm not going to since I'm not an animator. You can try out the preview version of 5.4 and let me know how it goes in the comment section. And if you are interested in learning about control rig blueprints, please let me know. I can make a separate video on that as well. Till then, please like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel. And if you want to learn the basics of IK retargeting, watch my previous tutorial video. The link is given in the description. So that's it for today. I will see you in the next video.